would do as he spoke, because I have written many speeches to say to you this morning. And knowing me, I'll deliver something else. I want you all to know that I did engage my daughter Sarah to help me write these remarks. And she remarked to me as we were sitting at the table, "Mommy, you just struck through everything I said." So I'm going to give you a few of the remarks that Sarah made, and I'm going to add a few of my own. And having listened to the speakers on the stage this morning, I'm going to try not to repeat anything that they've said. My daughter Sarah and I are truly honored to be a part of the McLeod's Way dedication. We want to thank Chancellor Ryden and his lovely wife, Lisa. We want to thank the Board of Trustees. We want to thank the university community, the St. Louis and Clayton community, our friends, our family, and all of those who were involved in planning this momentous occasion. I would also at this time like to thank many of you, though I plan to do it personally and will continue to do so in the months to come, for all of the good things that you have sent our way. Your thoughts, your hugs, your flowers, your gifts, the teas that you know I enjoyed as well as James, and for all of the condolences and letters of sympathy that I have received and continue to receive now about James' passing. He would be so amazed and pleased that you remembered me in this way. I used to tease him all the time, and I would say to him when he would tell me that, "You know, Clara, men usually die before women." And I'd say to him, "But you can't do that." And he would say, "Why not?" And I would say, "Well, if you left me here, there would be no one to come to my funeral." And he said to me, he smiled and he said, "I wish I could believe that, Clara." He said, "But knowing you, people will embrace you just as they embraced me at Washington University. They love you just as they love me. And I know that they'll take care of you should anything happen to me. And I want to thank you all because you've done just that." James and I came to Washington University 37 years ago as young professionals. We were embraced then and continue to be embraced with such warmth and kindness. It's hard to believe that the time has passed by so quickly. We've watched the campus change and grow. We have made lifelong friends and gained a lovable and extended family. And I just want to thank you all for all of the memories and support that you gave to James during his lifetime. Those memories and support were the things that kept him going to the very end. I asked him one day, as he was near the end of his life, was there anything that he really wanted to do? And I said to him, "You know, you can retire, and we can do things that you want to do." And he looked at me with that quizzical look on his face and twinkle in his eyes, and he said to me, "Baby, you know, I am doing what I want to do. I have done what I wanted to do." And he always reminded me then, when he said things like that, of the fact that he would tell me secretly, he would say, "I can never let my bosses know how much I enjoy my work." James, of course, valued his family. He always thought that family was the most important thing. He because he said they loved you when you were up, they loved you when you were down, they forgave you for your mistakes, and that they were willing to help you shepherd yourself into any new thing or new adventure that you wanted to do. So, when I think of him, I think of two things. One is that he thought of others before himself. And I know that because he did it at home with me and Sarah. I remember very vividly saying to him that I wanted to have a new family, a new member of our family. And I also remember forgetting it until one day he came home and he said, I've set up all of the arrangements and we can go about finding our daughter, Princess Sarah. He loved Sarah with all of his heart. And though he spent time with all of you, he never was too busy to hear from Princess Sarah. And so for that, I was very grateful. I know that James believed strongly in humanity. He thought that there was nothing like finding the best in all of us. He had a strong sense of family. He loved his brothers and his sisters. He made time for them. He loved his father and his mother. And he often talked about where he had come from. He was not ashamed of it. He carried it in his heart. And he often focused on what coming from that family meant to him. And so I want to leave two things with you. I don't have them very well connected, but there are two things that were very dear to James' heart. I was reminded of the first thing when I actually asked him one day about a saying that he had pasted to our refrigerator door. And it was by John Wesley. It was breadcrumbs. And when I asked him about retirement, he said to me, I don't believe in retirement, Clara. He says, I want to do all of the good I can by all of the means I can and all of the ways I can to all of the people I can for as long as I'm here. And that's what I remember about James. I remember going to bed at night, having papers all across the bed, having his glasses screwed on his face, and his telephone in his hands reading his emails. And I would wake up and look at him and say, what are you doing? Don't you ever sleep? And he would say, of course I do. He says, but I'm just catching up on a few things. So as I think of him now, I think of him catching up on a few things and remembering how much he loved the community at Washington University. He realized that it was a special community, a giving community, a community that gave so much to him that he could never have repaid it in any way. I also want to, at this time, publicly thank Bill and Hubie Danford, who became our parents away from our home. They took us into their homes and into their hearts, and for that, we will forever be grateful. I remember so dearly when I first came to the university, Bill came by the office, and he told me he was coming by just to see if James was there at work, and that's when I fell in love with him. So I want to thank you so much for that. So many people at the university have been kind to me and have been good to James, and I know he would want to thank each of you for that. And so this morning when I came to the Urban State of the Union address, I was handed a card, and I was trying to figure out how should I end the talk that told me how to do that. It was a card from Josh's mother, who was one of the urban scholars. And it talked about Josh thinking that James was the best thing that had happened to him. And it reminded me of the four questions that James always wanted each of us to ask. And it's the thing that I think I would like for each of you to remember when you see or hear about McLeod's Way. He was always interested in who am I? Where did I come from? Where am I going to? And what do I stand for? James was a man of great faith and of strong convictions, and he tried to do his best to live up to those convictions no matter what the challenge was. So as only a wife would do at the end, near the end of his life, I said to him, now just tell me, what would you like to be remembered for? And he looked at me and he smiled and he says, baby, I just want to be remembered as a good, decent human being. And your presence here tells me that he got his wish. And for that, I will be eternally grateful. Thank you so very much.
James McLeod.